I've worked here for over 3 years now, and it's been a fantastic 3 years working here. Yeah, I love working with customers. I've actually got to know most of the customers here. I mean, I see them mostly down Bowden Lane, like walking about, and they know me from calling numbers and all that, and I like mingling and making new friends and that.
Yeah, what do you think of the bingo working for the Hearns?
Very good, yeah.
At the moment,
it's better good. Here than it was at Channel, I must admit.
Oh, that's good.
The staff's better, the customers are better, and it really is much better here.
Okay, thank you.
I've been here 11 years.
Good.
Wow. On the sly?
Most of the staff are good.
The newcomers are quite working here.
Yes, they're not good to work for.
Yeah.
Could do with a pay rise.
That's a good one.
I've worked here 5 years.
And what are you actually doing?
I'm a bar manager.
Right. And how many staff you got working under you?
Six.
How do you find working here? Good.
Working here is lovely most of the time, but you do get the odd, awkward customers and little petty arguments and fights that you've got to deal with. But apart from that, it's just
like one hour of the dog's back.
Yep. But 99% of the time, it's good, yeah.
So are you excited for the 50th this week?
Yes, it should be good. All the entertainment and everything that we've got on should be a really good night. Yeah.
I'm John, my wife runs the kitchen here. She has done for about the last 20 years. I'm Tommy's personal assistant in Batman. And I enjoy coming every morning and staying most of the day.
You.
That's about it, I would think, yeah.
Ready? Hi, my name's Tracy. I've been at the Crown for about 19 years altogether. Started doing the karaoke about 15 years ago. We have enjoyable nights, you know. We have good customers, you know. We'll enjoy that little bit sing-song and that. Tuesdays, Thursdays, also sad days, you know. Staff, you know. That's debatable. But apart from that, you know, it's a really good time. You've got to come along to thoroughly enjoy it. But what else can I say? Come down, find out for yourself.
I'm Harry. I work on the bar downstairs in the side room. I've worked for the Hearns for over 40 years. Quite enjoyable. like mixing with the customers. It's very nice. The people are very pleasant who you work for. The customers can be nice to you sometimes. Sometimes.
I'm Dorothy Foster. I've worked for the Hearns for 36 years. I started off at the Imperial, and then when that closed down, we got transferred over here. The bosses are all nice to work for. They're not on your backs all the time. Some of the customers are a bit iffy, but they pay what wages, so that's why I just love working here. Well, I must have after being here this long.
How long have you been coming to the Crown Bingo for, Jimmy?
What's your best memory from the Crown going home?
Since it first opened.
End of every month.
And that was 1961?
That guy.
Aye. And how many family come now? You've got quite a few family that come down.
The whole lot of them comes. I've got seven in the family and all the grandmates. I've got about 23 grandbairns and oh, I'm forgetting all the rest of the grandbairns.
You like come to karaoke, don't you? On a Tuesday and a Thursday night and a Saturday night now, Jimmy.
Aye.
What do you actually sing, Jimmy?
I sing all sorts, Wonder at You and all sorts of songs that dance the night away. Mm.
And you used to come to the nightclub as well, did you, Jimmy?
Oh, aye, I come there.
In the olden days.
The what?
In the olden days.
The olden days, aye.
How long have you been a member, John, of Hearns Bingo?
10 years.
10 years?
Yes.
And you went to the Jarrow Hall? Did
yes.
you get me a member at the Jarrow Hall?
Yes.
And have you been coming to the Crown for the last couple of years?
No, 10 years. I've been coming here
10 years. 10 years as well?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Only went there for a couple of years at Jarrow and then I came here.
Did you have any big wins, John? See it?
No. No. No.
Do you like your pint of beer as well?
Love me pint of beer. Yes.
Did you know the Hearns as when they were young or not?
No.
No.
No. No. No.
So you weren't around in their days?
No. 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 I'm not. I was in the forces then. I was away 20 odd years in the forces.
Okay. How many nights a week do you come down?
Four.
Four nights?
Four nights. Okay.
Jimmy, how long have you been coming now?
40 odd years. Since I was 80.
You've had a big win.
Yeah, oh, one of the big ones, yeah.
How much was that for?
Well, it was nearly 200 grand, but we got 96. 96 grand.
That's a funny win. That was a couple of years back.
2006.
Probably was. Yeah,
yeah,
crowd wasn't
there. Yeah, that's right.
And you enjoyed the nightclub times, didn't you?
Oh, yes. Oh, I did well.
And how long have you been members of the Crown?
I'll tell a lie, since I was 17, I was too young, I'm 67 now.
I was coming when I was 16.
You're 50 years now?
And I'm 59.
Are you? You've been nearly 50 years?
I was 17.
I was coming when I was, 16, 17.
So how are you then? Tell us about the olden days, the nightclub days.
That's brilliant.
Excellent.
I could go up outside.
Excellent.
Excellent.
When the waitress service was on.
You know what's
waitress service?
When Vera and the
Margaret Duncan and the table,
used to have to put your hand up and they used to come and
I remember that was chock a block.
It was chock a. Had some great nights in here like.
I remember the bouncers on the door was brilliant.
Aye.
And you never had any trouble.
Black Bob and
Black Bob.
You've got a big family, Jimmy, as well, have you that
There's loads coming, my family.
Yeah. Your daughters have just started coming.
My daughters have just started to come. Aye.
Yeah, the bairns have just started to come.
Now what's killed is to stop the smoking.
Aye, the smoking.
It's killed them.
Smoking?
It's
killed a lot. Kills the hundreds, hasn't it?
That's the government for you though, isn't it?
It's brilliant, I like it.
But we've got to keep coming, Maria.
We have to.
It's not bingo, it's like a social
club. It's going from home, isn't it?
Well, we've tried the Mecca, we've tried the Majestic.
And
we didn't like it.
It's ice down
to me. It's just this.
This club's your place though, isn't it?
It's
not going nowhere.
It's not the staff, it's not the Hearns, it's the customer's place.
And everybody speaks to everybody.
Everybody,
aye. You can come by yourself and you don't have to be by yourself.
Can I catch you a bit when you're pissed?
I may say something I may regret.
So how long have you been coming here, Marie?
Well, I was 16 and 47 now. So it'll be 31 years. But it was a nightclub when I used to come.
You come for the nightclub?
Mm-hmm. And it was brilliant.
And then you start coming for the...
Great, or the bingo. Well, I didn't come to the bingo until later on. Now, I've been living round here for the last 15 years, right? And I've come in here for 15 years for the bingo. I know it's like, look, people are great in here. People are just brilliant.
Bosses are good.
You don't have to...
you can get away with murder with the Hearns, can't you?
It's not getting away with murder. It's just like...
It's all from
no, because they tell you how it is.
Because,
you know, if they tell you up, they tell you up. That's it. You've got
to
slap on the hand. But I tell you what, it's the most... How can I put it? Everyone comes in here because they love the crap. They love it up the bar staff. They love it up, like, use calling, everything. And I tell them, and the communication in here is just brilliant. And a laugh. And a laugh, I should say that.
Yes, yeah.
I've seen me coming in here best even when the bingo was on. But it was great because you know who I am.
Yeah.
Well, I'm not saying who I am, but it's like pissed, but I'm never...
You're not that bad.
Well, exactly. I'm not at all. No. Honestly, it's great.
Yeah, kids coming in now, aren't they?
Yes, well, I introduced our Kelly, where she's a bingo queen now. She always comes as soon as...
How old's Kelly?
She was 26, 25, 24. She loves it.
For a few years.
Yes. And she loves it because she can talk to me.
And the kids have their Christmas party, don't they?
Oh, God. I tell you what it is, that's the best thing. Well, no, it's not the best thing, but I tell you what it is, to have the Christmas party in that is unreal. What can other people have for £1.50?
That's right, aye.
For one, pantomime, like...
Food for the band.
The foot.
The Santa Claus.
The selection boxes, everything.
Well, there's your daughter there. Yeah. How are you, Ma?
How are you? And when did... Since I introduced you to this, just look at... When I introduced you, what happened? She's got the bingo butcher. She doesn't go down to Majestic or the...
No, I know.
Thingy's down here now. It's here.
Love it here.
Love it? Communications, everything. And I just don't know how you've put up with me for all these years.
Because we love you, that's why.
Exactly, yeah.
You used to be at the I was manageress for 7 years. I've been here since 1980. I started in 1980. Left in 2002. So I had 22 years and I was a manageress for 7 years.
And have you seen a difference in the bingo?
I have. Yes. A lot of difference. Yes. It's been a great club. Lovely customers. Gone well with all the customers. Also been doing the banking for a long, long, long time. It's been a success, the bank. Met a lot of people, but it's drawn out at Christmas.
You've been coming here for a long time as well, yeah. Haven't you?
Mm-hmm. So,
how long have you been coming here? Oh, 25 years.
Just any changes?
Tons. Well, it was more or less, the seating was all poor then. They all been changed. They built the extension on the side. Quite a no eye. But it's, I mean, it's quite all over now.
Years ago, you used to have to start the queue.
Yeah,
you just can't do the street.
The queue used to be from the outdoor side door to the metro station. Thursday night, when the shipyards got paid. That's when it was full.
Yeah.
Ollie, how long have you been a member here?
Well, from the first night it started, but the Imperial before that.
That was one of the other Hearns' clubs.
That was one of the Hearns' clubs. First of all, it was the cricket lads had it, then the Hearns bought it, yes. And it's my life. And when we first started coming here, the little man used to sit up in the corner and used to have the little machine, and the balls used to roll out. Then in the back room, we used to have a game of roulette, if we won, and a game of blackjack. Then we started with a nightclub, and we've had some fantastic nights in here. I've lived my life.
How do you think the brothers have actually coped over these 50 years?
Marvellous, marvellous. Five of the nicest lads that God ever put breath into. Five gentlemen, really and truly. And I'm not just saying it, because we've gone back a lot of years. Well, my youngest daughter's 50 in October. And on Friday night, when she was born, I was in the Imperial. And somebody says to me, "You've sweated all night, Ollie." I says, "What made you say that?" She says, "Look on your face." I says, "No, I'm in my labour." And I went home and my bairn was born. And she's 50 in October. So, lovely.
Anything else you want to track on?
No, honey, just enjoyed every session I've been to the bingo, and I hope it continues as long as I'm going, and I shall be here. Yes. Beg, borrow or steal, I shall be here. Is that it?
That's right. I'd
rather talk about coming here in the 70s.
Right. Well, that's what we need to hear.
The whole street used to come.
Right, okay.
Morland Road, White Leaves. The top one used to come out and knock everybody going down the street. Used to nearly fill the bus Thursday nights, years and years. My gran, who died when she was 93, came here every single night from the day it opened to the day she died.
Right.
Didn't you, Peter? Yeah. My mum used to come. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Right, sure. She won a couple of times, you know.
Oh, she didn't know.
She would have to come every day. Your dad used to work here, didn't he?
He did, yes.
How many years ago was that? Can you remember?
Many years ago since he finished.
When he was here?
He was here 1987. Yeah. Last time he was here.
Yeah, after that. Can you remember what the bingo night you said you when your dad was working here?
The buses. Well, Raymond and George, they were here. Jenny and Laura, like the Andy Laura and Matt Jenny. And my dad used to take Jenny home to Cornwall on the night. And used to sell the books. Like, had a little table downstairs, like selling the books.
This
is my dad. This one. And that was his friend Billy Rees. He was in a wheelchair as well. We're both in the wheelchair. And best friends, two of them. They worked here quite a while.
Selling the tickets with Jenny.
That's my dad selling the tickets with Jenny.
Your dad and your mum was never away from the bingo.
And my mum was always at the bingo. It was our second home.
I remember your mum.
It was our second home.
Jenny, Tommy, and Billy.
There's Billy on Elvis cheeks. Tommy with a tash.
And I forgot these two ladies. They were relations as well, I think, weren't they? I think they were relations.
Donkey's years.
Did you ever go to the Jarrow or the Imperial?
I went to Jarrow once, and I beat the Imperial once with me sister Norma. Norma.
Yeah. Right.
I like here, I feel comfortable here. Everybody's great to us, I just tell them what I think of them. If they don't like it, tough.
What about the bingo? How long have you been coming?
Oh, years, man, years.
What's the changes at the bingo?
What's the what?
Changes, the way they do things now, what they did when you came.
Well, it's just, everybody seems to be great, they're sociable. I love the games on the boards, I put plenty of money in. Sure up. There's a bee. I'll tell you my life story. Sorry. And just everybody, all the staff's great, you know? It's just like a family. You're among family when you're in here. That's why I like up here. I brought my daughter, I brought my other daughter, and I've told loads of friends and they've all come up. That's as simple as that. That's all I know. You know? Okay, cut. Right, thank you. Whoa, phew.
Since it was full, and I used to sit on the stairs.
Oh, right.
That's a long time ago. About 13 years, I think.
13 years, you've been
like
company.
Aye.
Do you enjoy the company here when you
yes.
come?
Yes. I like all the stuff and everything here, you know. Majestic, and it wasn't the same.
That's what I like.
And I'm friendly down there, you know.
Friendly down at the... Oh. How many nights you come a week?
Twice.
Twice?
Wednesdays and Saturdays, yeah. Right. I don't know what to say now.
£100 a full house. Free game, orange ticket, First number. 62, 62. 1 4, 14. All the 8s.
Your name's Liz Tate?
Phyllis
Tate. Phyllis Tate. Phyllis
Tate. Them two, go to Sheila and take them with you, them two. Hiya.
Can you get this stone a bit? Anyway, ladies and gentlemen. Just for your benefit only, right, the one and only Memory Lane. And the name, right?
I'll tell you something.
There are a pack of musicians from White Days.
Polish girls, yes, some of the girls, yeah.
Not me, no, I'm not like that, I'm your mama. Anyway, for your entertainment, Memory Lane, followed by the one and only Ned Kelly. Thank you.
Thank you.
Harry, you got some bears here.
The
bears
here. Go on, Ned, will you? Go on, I can see you sneak out. You want to see Ned, Kenny? Give him a round of applause, come on. Come on down. There you go, Ned.
Good evening, ladies and gents, distinguished guests and fellow athletes. I just worked it out, I was speaking to Billy there, I just worked out, it's 27 years since the last time I was here. I must have been good, the book is back this fucking sharp. All right, there you go. Where's Jack? Just down a little bit, Dave.
Turn it down a bit.
Aye, if you don't mind it. Billy Hearns in? Where are you, Bill? How's your lass and my kids? Well, I feel I've got a feeling tonight's going to be a nice little show because I feel like I know every single face in this room. Dave, could you turn it down just a little bit? It's feeding back, son. You didn't mind. He's been the chemist. He forgot his fucking grease in 2000. Well, I don't know what's going to happen tonight, but I'll give it my best shot. Because I've had a load of bad news. I lost a wife last night. What a game of fucking cards that was. I stacked the prime of threes in case I win the fat fucker back. Well, I've got some good news there for next week for the ladies. See what's happening next week on the telly. Big Brother. You all want that, girls? Well, next week, we've got Celebrity Big Brother to start it off. And I've asked people to write in and ask who they would like on the show. Well, I've suggested Rosemary West. Can you imagine that big daft Geordie presenter? 11 a.m. All the housemates are now in the fucking garden. Rose has completed her task. I said to her last night, I was in bed with her last night. She says, I've got something to tell you. I said, what is it? She says, I'm seeing another man. I said, well, rub your fucking eyes then. You've been a smashing crowd. You've got a great band coming on, all rock and roll stuff. What we used to do years ago. Thanks for being a nice crowd. Good luck, God bless you. And enjoy the rest of the show.
Come on, let's hear your hands. Come on. Well done, Dad. Come on, you do that, Dad. Give a nice round of applause. Well done, Eddie.
And tonight upstairs up in the big old got some marvellous entertainment for you. We've got Memory Lane. We've got Pete McDonald off Lowly. We've got Tracy on karaoke. And we have the man himself, Bobby Patterson. So I'm sure you're staying for the entertainment afterwards. Very, very good to see you. And as well as all week, we've had a £20 free game, £100, £20 night, £100 free game. Tomorrow evening, that is £100 a line, £500 a full house. Free game tomorrow evening. And also tomorrow evening, we have Darren Corbin, an hour of Darren Corbin upstairs. He said he's going to excel on the stage for you tomorrow evening. With that, on your free game, it's orange ticket, £20 a line, £100 a full house. First number, any line, orange ticket.
15th anniversary celebrations of the Crown Bingo here in Tyne Dock. We've got a lineup of entertainment for you tonight. We've got a quartet who are hiding behind the curtain called Memory Lane, who are going to play a few golden oldies for you. We've got a great singer called Pete MacDonald, who's on his way as we speak. But opening the show, we've got the legendary Geordie comedian, Mr. Bobby Pattinson. Before Bobby comes on, here he is. Before Bobby comes on, Tracy's going to sing you a little song to get you into the mood. Are you ready, Tracy?
Come on. Yeah. I
Bobby Pattinson. Please put your hands together. I'm not as young as I look, I'm telling you. Hello, how are you? Right. Thank you very much, thank you. Happy 50th birthday, Crown. Give yourselves a round of applause. Come on, give them another round. And Bill, marvellous. I tell you what, I'm just... I'm just a few years short of being here on the opening night. I think I was here 40 years ago, Bill, is that right? 40 years ago when I entertained. This is what you call a quick return booking. That's how well I did last time. But where's all the... Anyway, it's a pleasure to be here. I'm opening because, unfortunately, Pete, great singer Pete, is not here yet, but he's on his way, so you've got a full show. But this is unusual for me to open, but I don't mind because I'm working to lovely people. I suppose we're a split audience in here where football is concerned. Where's the Southern Squatters? Where's the Newcastle supporters? I was there this afternoon. I think we both had a good result, mate. I was there this afternoon, Newcastle weren't that hot, I'm telling you. Got a corner after 40 minutes and did a lap of honour. It was so bad. Anyway, it's a pleasure to see you, without doubt. A bit noisy. Get a poor sodded chance. Without doubt, we're the greatest sense of humour in the world in the North East, you know. I always used to say that by coming on stage and impressing upon people that in the North East we had the greatest sense of humour in the world, and it was because of our dialect.
Quiet!
Because of the Joey dialect, where we can say things that sound like funny because of dialect. I mean, for instance, is it anyone of the people from the south, or anybody sort of south of Darlington, because they're southerners as far as we're concerned, and hardly knows Aunt Geordie's when we say things like, how we were told with this, gambling on your hunger as a cope your queens. A bag's yet goat. Dee how the vultures are kept it. It's a